Here we go, guys. The final Monday Night Five, you know, is the Russian local Bilarov, you know, submit two fights with new hooks, and Felipe Pena submitted two fights as well. Two best fighters under 95, you know.
I think it's my guess would be this fight winning a submission. What do you think?
Yes, I think it will be a submission. Felipe is flying really well. I think it might take his back, and he's doing great on the escaping the heel hooks, taking the back and go for the real naked choke. It's going to be a tough match. Don't get me wrong. 20 seconds. This guard pull. I believe Felipe is going to end up.
Tiger there, man. You can see his determination in his eyes.
He really want to.
Yeah,
he never got so close.
Shoot for Russia. That's really dependent right now. Arguably the best no-gi grappler
in the world. Yeah. You know, at the moment, he managed to win the ADCC world title, absolute champion, meeting with Shisha, beating Gordon Ryan. You know, this guy is a legend, living legend, competing every tournament. He won pretty much everything that he competed this year. And now, playing his main game now on the bottom. It's going to be a tough mission for Bilarov to fight Felipe Pena in his best
tonight. I agree. You can see they're not, neither of them are in a hurry. They understand it's a five-round fight. So this is something that's been going on for a while. I think they're kind of preparing for that. But I can see once the opportunity arises, it turns into a war over who's going to get whose heel.
Yeah.
Who's
back. For example, we're talking here, Felipe Pena, the guy that managed to beat the guy that is specialist in heel hooks, Gordon Ryan, twice. Yeah. And we've seen that Bilarov is the best position he has for heel hooks. I don't think he'll be able to get as close.
I don't.
And Felipe is used to be.
I'm not going to say anything about him again.
Exactly, yeah.
Tonight, so
it's hard.
Yeah.
But
like, if there's a guy out there that
could beat him, would be Felipe, right? And vice versa, to be honest. At the ACB. Felipe is doing good by keeping his right foot between the legs there. He really wants that heel hook. Bilarov wants that left foot from Felipe passing through between his legs. Felipe is defending really well by holding the Bilarov's left leg. He looks really strong. Can't 10 seconds to go. It's an exciting match. First round 2-0 to Felipe Pena. Second round. Second out of five rounds. Felipe Pena with the Storm Rashford and Villarreal with the Atlas Rashford. Round two. That's going to be a penalty for each of them.
Yeah, these guys are going to really have to push it because you don't want to be racking up those penalties.
So remember, it's a
five round.
Exactly.
You know, it's going to be hard to be active all of those.
Now you're allowed two guards.
Didn't want to take any chances. I
thought he was first, though.
Yeah, he was first, but I think Luke didn't want to take any chances. That's why he stood up.
Yeah.
Smart.
Combat.
Very good distraction. See, everything is about getting the ball of the opponent to get the very well. That's a good result for the home goal.
Wow, pretty good. Great. The home goal.
Well defended by Villarreal.
Fading out and giving away the sweep. Moving off is really impressive. He's going toe-to-toe with Luigi Pena.
He's doing a good job, and it's not going to be an easy job for passing his guard either. For the first time, Felipe Pena is on top, right? He has a great pass, and if Villarreal don't turn his back, he'll be fine. But if once he turns his back, Felipe's best position is taking the left. And then once he gets there, he's over. You know, like, but Villarreal is really active there, trying to get the heel hooks. You know, Felipe's going to be blasting the pass, so he turns the back. That's going to be the game. The same way that Felipe Pena has to do something else before to put a sweep, that's what Villarreal needs to do against Felipe. Cannot be predictable. You need to try to take the attention and set up traps.
Just be crystal evil. You saw like Jack was stuck there. Felipe has a hard time getting around him. Round two. Won the first by 2 points. Look like we're gonna win the second by 2 points. Nice. Late drag attempt there by Felipe.
Still my luck.
I was just gonna say.
Maybe again.
Act like it's not there.
Capitalizing on the points.
I think that's the way they go to pass or because they just hold the right.
They need to back off and come back.
Yeah, but I think that Filip right now he's kind of studying Belarov and waiting. He knows he's winning this round. There's no point.
Yeah,
unless you can score
not wasting time,
5
you know?
Points, there's no time to really push yourself.
Yeah.
But I guess he's looking for Belarov.
30 seconds. Second round won by Filip.
This is round 3. Bulyanov against Filip Penna. Round 1 and 2. The question is now, will they change strategies? Well, you think Filip Penna is just going to manage? He is, in fact, he won round 1 and 2. You think Bulyanov is going to switch strategies?
I think now Filip is going to be a little bit more cautious. He did the hardest beat, which had 2 rounds ahead on Belarov. You know, now it's not time to make no mistakes. And Belarov already felt that his strategy is not working. He needs to change. And every time when there is a change, the winner has a big chance and of manipulation.
Yeah.
You know, because he can see things under pressure or the other end.
That was a penalty.
Yeah. Both of them? Now you're allowed to pull guard. I think. That's a very good move. That's a
situation.
That guillotine. The guillotine is on. It's on. It's on. It's on. It's on. It's on. Just a little bit, just on a big hit there, but still on though.
Barely.
Goodness. It's a tap!
Yeah.
It's a tap!
Incredible.
Filip Penna.
Amazing.
Submission.
All submission.
All submission. Champion of ACBJJ 9.